Counts and Connect is a COVID-born innovation that came about in the early stages of the pandemic last March. A few mental health and addictions organizations came together to brainstorm how we could ensure that people had very quick and seamless access to same day or next day counseling sessions, given that for many of us, our physical doors were closed to service and we'd all pivoted to virtual care in those early days of the pandemic.
The crisis created this opportunity for all of us to come together and figure out very quickly what we needed to do to get things up and running.
We started off as 7 organizations. We're now up to 22 partnering organizations, pooling resources and services on the site.
Shared values, like I think that is what grounded us throughout the whole project. And one of the, you know, even in our slogan and what's on our website is really services for everyone. And by everyone, it really is everyone across the lifespan. When we look at the population of Ottawa, I mean, we are a diverse community. We're only getting more diverse. And, you know, the intersection of what happened with the pandemic, but also what happened with Black Lives Matter and all the inequities that were surfaced.
Health equity and accessibility and ensuring that equitable access for all has been a core tenet of the collaborative table. We recognize that it was one thing to offer same day, next day appointments and another thing to look at what are some other ways that we can expand on what we're doing. And the equity piece came into play when we realized, okay, we're able to offer French appointments, English appointments, across the ages, because we've got partners who support children and families and youth, addictions issues, mental health. And then the next level of that was ensuring that populations that may not have always felt welcomed in certain spaces and or felt like they had equitable access to mental health and addictions care had a space to do that within the site.
Early on in the development of the Counts and Connect platform and service, Wabanoag Center for Aboriginal Health came on as a key partner in mental health supports for Indigenous children, youth, and families.
Within our partner organizations, we came together and we developed a portal specifically to meet the needs of LGBTQ individuals and communities, and as well as the African Caribbean Black communities. The promise is you're getting a therapist who is a registered psychotherapist, but also identifies as being part of the community. So the level of safety just goes up a notch in terms of, you know, who they're connecting into for care. And that's because we've kept the client and community at the forefront of all decision making. And at our collaborative table, we also have client partners who help to inform this process. So they help to keep it real.
The really interesting shift for us service providers was just capitalizing on a digital solution. Everything we do, we need to be thinking about the user. Where when I think about adding a service or when I think about how we're going to refer into a service, what I'm thinking about is how's that going to look like when the person accesses the website? We're like really mapping out the client journey from that first point in and making sure at all times that stays low barrier and easy and simple and seamless to use. I think that's the game changer.
And we're at a spot in our development with the with our digital health platform to be able to nuance our leverage the fact that we've got multiple languages in our counseling pool, and now we've got the ability on our platform, and we'll be launching it in the next couple of weeks. And 2 other provinces have modeled a similar service. It's been replicated across Canada. And is a scalable initiative. I think I'm just super proud at the impact it's made. To date, we've served over 8,000 people. People are getting care really quickly. Yeah, and that was the goal.